I'm from ROJGAR24, and ROJGAR24 is the most innovative online job portal. Over the past decade, ROJGAR24 has become a prominent name in the recruitment industry. Anyways, now today we are going to talk about skill development in India, part 2. The main function of the PM's National Council on Skill Development are as under: to lay down overall broad policy objectives, financing and governance models and strategies relating to skill development, like to review the progress of schemes and guide on mid-course corrections, additions and closure of parts or whole of any particular program's scheme, and coordinate public sector or private sector initiative in a framework of collaborative action. The NSDCB coordinates the skill development efforts of a large number of central ministries, departments and states. The National Skill Development Corporation, like NSDC, is a public-private partnership set up to catalyze the setting up of large scale for a profit sustainable vocational institution in the country by encouraging private sector participation and providing low-cost funding for training capacity. In addition, it is expected to fund supporting systems such as quality assurance, labor market information systems and train the trainer facilities. Thus, the three-tie structure together facilities and implementation of skill development on the ground through three main channels like central ministries, the state government and private and public training organization. So in the central government, around 20 ministries are closely involved in the skill development. These ministries mainly operate in one of two ways: through setting up own training capacity in a specific sector. Example of such ministries include Ministry of Labour and Employment, Ministry of Agriculture and Ministry of Health and Family Welfare and whatever, or through providing per training cost of training for a specific target population. Example of such ministries include Ministry of Rural Development, Ministry of Women and Child Development and etc. So ROJGAR24 works closely to bridge the gap between talent and opportunities and efforts end-to-end requirement solution. ROJGAR24 job brings candidates and top employers under one roof. Will ROJGAR24 HR conclave brings top HR leaders to share insight on latest trends, innovations and best practices in the HR industry, and also has a large reach through its print product. So most state governments also have set up state skill development missions as nodal bodies to anchor the skill development agenda in the state. SSDMs are expected to play a significant role in escalating the pace of skilling through identification of key sector for skill development in the state, as well as coordinating with central ministries and state line departments, as well as industry and private training organization. Each state has adopted a structure of SSDM that best suit for the local environment and the state vision for skill development. Will some state have elected to form the SSDM as a society or corporation under the chief secretary or the chief minister? Others have housed it in under relevant departments such as labor, human resources development or planning. Many states are starting to set year-wise targets for skill development, specifying the state budgetary allocation and complementing government's effort by encouraging private investment, issues and reforms needed in skill development. And next, in education system. The current education system does not focus on training young people in employable skills that can provide them with employment opportunities. Today, a large section of India's labor force has outdated skills. With current and expected economic growth, as this challenge is going to only increase further, since more than 75% of new job opportunities are expected to be skill-based. So, framework for the creation of an efficient education delivery model should include: like availability, accessibility, and adaptability and acceptability. So availability, the topic in this, the capacity of just over 4 million a year needs to be upgraded substantially in order to meet the targeted skill requirements till 2022. There exists a significant mismatch between the massive populace of unemployed youth and existing vacancies, which leads to low employability quotient of a pupil. It is therefore a critical step to focus on the needs of both learners and the labor market in order to make the requisite kinds of skill available by forging partnerships between public administrators, suppliers of educational services, industry and civil society. And next, accessibility. The accessibility of skill-based training face a huge challenge on account of India's large geographical priority, difficult terrain and varying socio-economic conditions. Some of the states have limited access to such training. As a result, the population comprises a large unskilled workforce. Significant disparities exist across states in terms of socio-economic factors such as education levels, income levels and industrial growth and whatever. So adaptability. In this topic, the economic growth over the years has only brought for the shortcoming of skill development processes. Learners require a national vocational qualification framework that offers vertical mobility for those pursuing skills and enables learners to shift from skill-based training to academics and vice versa. They need a clear vocational qualification framework for competency standards, accreditation and accreditation. And next, acceptability. So the skill development programs being imparted to learners should meet their needs in terms of quality of infrastructures like ICT and physical infrastructure, pedagogy and skill delivery methods. The current education system does not lead to train young people in employable skills who are open to immediate employment opportunities. With current and expected economic growth, this problem is expected to aggravate as more than 75% of the new job opportunities are expected to be skill-based. As a result, there is a need to develop an advanced curriculum framework derived from industry best practices. It is equally critical to use these upcoming and widely used learning approaches to design skill development programs in order to train learners with what is relevant and not obsolete. So Rojgar 24 connects job seekers and recruiters by accurately matching candidate profiles to the relevant job openings through an advanced way matching technology. While most job portals only focus on getting candidates the next job, but Rojgar 24 focuses on the entire career growth of candidate. So our website from Rojgar 24, www.rojgar24.in, and now you call us 8800973322. So friends, wish you all the best and thank you so much.